We only have a minute to go, and I want to ask you, the U.S. Labor Department has just released its latest unemployment numbers as you were speaking, showing more than 3.8 million people filed for unemployment benefits in the last week. So that brings the total number to 30 million people who have filed for unemployment in just 6 weeks. Talk about what has happened in this 2 months, what you think needs to happen. This, as the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has said, states should simply go bankrupt unless they agree to a Republican austerity plan, and then they might get some U.S. government aid.
Yeah, I mean, this statement is particularly crazy. I mean, we had this kind of statement back in the 30s, you know, what we call the liquidationist ideology, you know, let's liquidate, you know, bad firms, bad banks, bad states. But, you know, of course, this is the worst policy you can imagine, both in terms of social consequences and in terms of macroeconomic consequences. Look, I think, you know, coming back to Joe Biden and the Democratic Party, I think Joe Biden will be really well inspired to borrow some of the new ideas that were put forward by Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, you know, including a progressive wealth tax on billionaires, including more investment in public hospitals, in public universities. You know, I think this is the time for the Democratic Party to show to you know, the middle class and the lower middle class and the lower socioeconomic groups that, you know, they care about redistribution and they care about improving the minimum wage, you know, which is what the Democratic Party stood for, you know, until the 60s, 70s, or, you know, 80s. And then what I show in my book, Capital and Ideology, which, by the way, I should say it's a very readable book. You know, it's a bit long, but it can really be read. It's not technical at all, and it's a broad, you know, history of inequality regime across societies. And I show that the Democratic Party in the U.S., you know, starting, as you were saying, you know, in the 50s, 60s, just like Social Democratic Party in Europe, gradually lost touch with the more disadvantaged electorate. And I, you know, I compare all these countries and timing together. And, you know, my conclusion is that this is largely because they failed to renew their policy package and to keep a redistributive ambition. And I think many of the, you know, lower class and lower middle class voters have just stopped voting. So now some are also voting for Trump, and in Europe some are also voting for the Nationalist Party. I think largely for lack of a better alternative, and they feel that, you know, protection and return to the nation state and the frontiers of the nation state at least will protect them a little bit more than nothing at all. I'm not sure they are so optimistic that, you know, all the gesticulation by people like Trump or Marine Le Pen in France will do a lot of good, but at least, you know, they see something new.